innovation and professional responsiveness. We equally had another lecture on RSM and barrack security. And we had another one yesterday on the impact of personnel welfare on and professional responsiveness. However, the DG of the Nigerian Army Resource Center thought it wise and thought it well to bring someone who can represent our children. And for this reason, we decided to bring an awesome young lady. I call her a youngster. Permit me to read her profile. Splendour Joe King was born 3rd of January 2006. She is 10 years old. She's the author of a book, Effects of Terrorism on Children. She is currently the first child in the world to have written a book on terrorism and to champion the crusade on child education on this subject, because she believes that children are the grassroots solution to this fight. Her foundation is called Splendour Child Empowerment International Foundation. She has some recognitions which are listed as follows. National Peace Ambassador, which was awarded by National Orientation Agency. Human Rights Advocate for National Human Rights Commission. She's equally the Peace Ambassador, which was awarded by the Institute of Peace and Conflict Resolution. She has delivered speech at various places, which are as follows. 1, the Office of the Chief of Defense Staff. 2, Office of the National Security Advisor. 3, Office of the Chief of Army Staff. 4, Ministry of Defense. 5, Office of the Chief of Naval Staff. 6, the World Bank Office of Nigeria. 7, UNESCO Regional Office in Nigeria. 8, Head of Service of the Federation, and many other places. She has also been a guest speaker at various places, which are National Security Summit organized by National Orientation Agency, National Program on Radicalization, Deradicalization, and Counter-Radicalization organized by the Institute of Peace and Conflict Resolution. 3, the Day of African Child Celebration organized by Ministry of Women Affairs and Social Development in collaboration with UNICEF. Ladies and gentlemen, without further ado, join me with a resounding round of applause as I invite this young star, a talented young lady, to come and deliver a 20-minute lecture on the effects of terrorism on children, Miss Splendour Joe King.
Material. My second reason is the fact that when we change a child today, a generation could be changed. Since those who became parents today were once children like me, I strongly believe that permanent records like this could serve as a good source of information for children's education in the future. Terrorism is a virus with grave consequences in our society, especially we, the young ones, whose future needs to be safeguarded. We must never underestimate the dangers of this virus in children who constitute the most vulnerable group. As children, we seek for a world in which we can live free from fear and where threats of terrorist attack do not define our daily lives. We are all aware of the need for us to build a safe society, a society that is free of terrorism, a society that recognizes that human life is a valuable asset, and that no individual or group has the right to take life. To achieve this, adequate attention should be paid to children. This is because that child ignored on the streets could be useful in the fight against terrorism. Terrorism, however, is not just war of weapons and ammunition, but also of ideologies. It is these ideologies that we must work hard to change through orientation and reorientation. This is because, in the event of any attack, children have always been the most affected, and at times, their vulnerability made them susceptible to these terrorists. We have seen children being used as child soldiers, and in recent times, we have also seen them being used to detonate IEDs, which have taken many lives. Their innocence made them unsuspected, and that has led to loss of many lives. It is in view of these that I have been carrying out campaigns for child education and the dangers of this evil. The effects of terrorism is always devastating on a nation, investors, people, and more especially children who have been my passion. Its effects on children cannot be overemphasized, ranging from death, separation from their families, fear and depression, to mention but a few. There is so much that can be done by the schools, our families, religious organizations, and the government to reduce the impact of terrorism on children. Some of these are enumerated in my book. My point of view is that educating children early about this evil will give them a full knowledge of what terrorism is. We cannot shy away from the fact that this evil is happening around us. And that is why I am advocating that children should be carried along in this fight. In my book, whatever lessons of history that is passed is based on facts on ground, not stories in the mind, on the substance of what has actually taken place, not on the sentiments of some interested parties. On the testimony of victims and witnesses themselves, not from the memories of casual observers. We must therefore endeavor to use all the languages we have to see that the children are not kept in the dark of the happenings around them. I see this as the imminent thing to do now, so as to rid our world of this evil. According to Nelson Mandela, and I quote, education is the most powerful weapon we can use to change the world. Reports have shown that many children have been displaced by Boko Haram activities in the Northeast, while millions of school-aged children are still not in school. The future of these children is my greatest concern. It is in line with the above. My foundation, Splendour Child Empowerment International Foundation, was established to assist children who are out of school, children who are victims of terrorism, and all unfortunate occurrences, regardless of their background. I want to use this opportunity to appreciate the Nigerian Army for their efforts in the fight against terrorism. You have done well for us, because where we are today in this fight is not where we used to be. And we know that with God on our side, we are overcomers. As education is an enhancer, ignorance is also a killer. We must make haste to educate our young ones on the dangers and effects of terrorism, and also what they should do when they are forced to carry out terrorist acts. No child, not even one, deserves to die because of ignorance. Having said all these, I would like to propose the following. Does my book, The Effects of Terrorism on Children, which has been approved by Nigerian Educational Research and Development Council, NERDC, and Federal Ministry of Education for Children Education, be adopted by the Nigerian Army for all the schools in Nigeria. This will help in the radicalization and de-radicalization programs. These forums should be created where the children can interact with their peers who are a positive influence. This will serve as an inspiration and motivation to them. The children with creative abilities be encouraged, as this will create room for healthy competition and thereby enabling the children to turn their energies to more positive and creative feelings. But we must, as a matter of urgency, get children informed instead of reform, because the latter is more expensive and time consuming. Without taking much of your time, I would, however, wish to encourage you in the following. To be focused no matter the situation, just because there is power in focus, to not give importance to any distractions. Always embrace change in your operations, thereby training moral and ethical values. Because, according to Gandhi, be the change that you wish to see in the world. Your physical and mental fitness, which is a prerequisite to duty, should be maintained. This will help you to remain as alert and make sound decisions even under any stressful conditions. One of the greatest attributes of a good leader is the ability to sacrifice personal gains and comfort for the sake of his followers. For example, like the chief of army staff, he has been an encouragement to the troops because he led the troops to the war front. And another time, I watched him on TV. He acted with the troops and he even served them. You know, this is a kind of leadership and loyalty that we must all emulate. Remember, again, And he also said the best way to find yourself is to lose yourself in the sense of others.
I, however, urge you to seek for such attributes.
It is important to know, therefore, that as far as ends, you are like the grease that lubricates each unit of command. Your ability to develop teamwork spirit will give you make your work easier. Permit me also to acknowledge the love and support of your families, who even in the face of dangers and uncertainties, keep the courage to move on. Finally, on behalf of the children of this great nation, I appreciate and salute you all in all your efforts in keeping our nation together and your loyalty to our fatherland. We believe in you and know that you continue to give your best to our nation. I therefore thank you for listening to me and God bless the Nigerian Army.
Thank you very much for that incisive lecture. Now, moving to the high table, we would like to take the comment from the representative of the Chief of Army Staff, Major General Abdi Abubakar.
The Director General, my beautiful girl, participants, parents of the presenter, gentlemen. I'm really touched by all the words that came out from the mouth of this young girl. We all know, for those of us that are either serving in the Northeast or have visited the Northeast, know the effect of terrorism. Especially to women and children. If you have visited any IDP, you will know what this young girl is talking about. And if you have traveled to Maiduguri or Damaturu, then you will understand exactly everything that she has said. I hold on my tears as I was listening to her. And I was just recapping my memory of all my visits to my school. I'll share one bad story with two people. We all know what happened on the 14th of March 2014, where Hiva Barak was embedded. Thereafter, there was a lot of problems. And a lot of arrests were made. And Hiva Barak became a place where we detained the Boko Haram suspects, men, women. And I was charged with the responsibility of going there to see them. There I went one day, and I saw a lady who was in pain, a pregnant woman. And in the detention camp, we have a clinic there, for those of you that have been there. And we called the nurse. While she was there, they took her to the room. That's a room demarcated as a hospital. The lady gave birth to a baby boy. And we were all happy, at least she did not die. And they took her in. They bathed her, bathed the baby, and she came back. And there and then we said, okay, what name are we going to give this baby? I said, which baby? I said, the baby that you have just given that. I said, if you like, give the child your name. You can see there is no love between the mother and the child. That is one story that will live with me all my life. So then who is the father? He said, how do I know? So imagine how that child is going to grow. I left back to do all I went to do in Maiduguri. But that word, how do I know, was resonating on my head all throughout, today till tomorrow. That is all what this lady is telling us today. The effects of terrorism on children. This country is sitting on a time bomb. The time bomb is the children that there will be a time when there will be a generation of bastards. Let us not keep ourselves and just say it does not concern us. These children are going to migrate to other places, and you want to know who the father is, you search forever, you never know. And maybe somebody that you know wants to get married to this kind of children. We must try as our parents. In the last 1 year, I will always say that so much has been achieved in bringing to an end. But terrorism is evil, like she said. Terrorism is dehumanizing the human being, especially women and children. They do it all in the name of religion, but it is all false. For those of you that are out there, any camp that is cleared, something is always there. Drug. Enhancing drugs. Condom. And all what not. I have not seen that religion that permitted rape. I have not seen that religion that said pick women as souvenirs. I have not seen that religion that says carry people's children as slaves. Of course, what they are doing is not. We are talking about the local one. Think about Yemen, Syria, Iraq. It is going on everywhere. I want to, on behalf of the Chief of Army Staff, thank Splendour for coming to remind us all what we know. To let us know that it is better to be human being than to dehumanize human being. And I want to tell you, this sky is your beginning. I took time to really listen to her, and I'll collect the tape to really show my own children. And it is when all of us talk to our children that they will not fall into wrong hands. You will never know the good thing and the good life your own child is living until you go to the Northeast. All those that say wrong things about the Northeast is because they don't even know the road there. They have never been there. It is what the press told them. If you are an atheist and you don't even know the existence of God, if you go to Northeast, I'm sure you'll be more religious than the Pope. I'm saying this. Once again, Splendour, thank you so much and wish you all the best in life. Thank you.
Senior officers, participants, may I humbly invite the special guest of honor to have a handshake with our guest speaker.